subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
The Great Barrier Reef's status has now been lowered. That is, it has worsened and it is now marked as critical in its health status by the International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN. The biggest threat to the reef is, of course, the worsening climate crisis, which is also the biggest threat to all of Earth's natural world heritage sites like Tanzania's Kilimanjaro National Park or the Yellowstone National Park in the US. In India too, Kaziranga, Sundarbans, Great Himalayan National Park are all natural world heritage sites. But in this video, we're going to talk about the Great Barrier Reef. We'll discuss what it is, what its ecosystem is, and what it was like, what coral is, what bleaching is, and what's happening at the reef. My name is Sandhya Ramesh, and this is Pure Science. The Great Barrier Reef is the world's largest coral reef system. Corals are marine invertebrates that live in tight colonies. These build hard skeletal structures made of calcium carbonate in tropical waters that they inhabit, called reefs. Each individual coral, called a polyp, does this by excreting an exoskeleton, and over generation, this exoskeleton builds up into what eventually becomes a reef. Coral reefs have been around for over 480 million years. Coral reefs are often called rainforests of the sea because they sustain some of the world's most diverse ecosystems. They occupy less than 0.1% of the world's oceans by area, but they support more than 25% of all marine species. They are found in shallow tropical waters. The Great Barrier Reef is about 20,000 years old and is the world's largest barrier reef. A barrier reef is one that runs parallel to the shoreline. This one stretches for almost 2,000 kilometers. It supports an incredible diversity of life, including many vulnerable and endangered species. Large populations of whales depend on the reef. Over 1,500 species of fish live on it. It houses multiple species of sea snakes, turtles, crocodiles, sharks, stingrays, mollusks, snails, seagrasses, frogs, seahorses, seaweed, and even birds. Many birds use the reefs to breed and help propagate the plants that live there. Many local indigenous populations also depend on the reef culturally as well. But coral reefs are fragile and they are highly sensitive to temperature changes. Across the globe, coral reefs are under threat from rising temperatures, ocean acidification, excess nutrient runoffs, overfishing, and many more such factors induced by humans. We know that what happens to coral reefs is that they bleach. But what is bleaching? For that, let's first look at why coral reefs are so colorful. We've all seen at least one photo or a video of coral reefs in our lifetimes, and the visuals are stunning. They're vivid and the colors are out of this world. And corals are able to be so colorful because they do not perform photosynthesis. For photosynthesis to occur, chlorophyll is what is needed, and that is a green pigment. Instead, coral polyps have an interdependent, mutually beneficial, symbiotic relationship with a microscopic algae or algae-like protozoa called zooxanthellae. These live inside coral tissues and they perform photosynthesis. They release energy from photosynthesis, which then the coral absorbs for its own metabolism, and in return, the zooxanthellae get carbon dioxide and a place to live. Interestingly, even though we spoke about photosynthesis, corals are not plants. They look like they're plants because they look like the colorful trees that are sprouting from the ground, from the ocean floor, and because they are sessile or immobile. However, they are classified as animals because they cannot make their own food. So it's because of this relationship with zooxanthellae that corals are able to absorb energy and make colored proteins, which are fed from the energy that's received from zooxanthellae. Corals are sensitive, to not just temperature, but also to light, to infections, and to any kind of changes in the environment. And when there are abnormal conditions in the seas, such as rising temperatures like it is right now, or increased acidification, this mutual symbiotic bond between corals and the zooxanthellae breaks down. And then what happens is that for short-term survival and for immediate source of nutrients, the coral either consumes the zooxanthellae or expels it from its tissues. This then leads to the reef developing a white appearance, and the term is called bleaching. Now, these zooxanthellae provide the corals with almost 90% of their energy needs. So the corals start to starve when bleaching occurs. Technically, the corals aren't dead when bleaching starts to occur, but they will start to die as soon as the zooxanthellae are gone. However, right now, today, as compared to 1995, over half of the world's corals have died. In the Great Barrier Reef, mass bleaching events have occurred regularly since 1995, and in the past few years, quite consistently. Now it is expected to become an annual occurrence. But it's not just rising temperatures. The Great Barrier Reef is a threat from pollution because the rivers of Australia run into the reef during flooding season. Much of the water comes from farming. There's also overfishing of vital species that sustain the ecosystem that is contributing to the decline of the Great Barrier Reef. The government of Australia is now taking more active steps to prevent further decline and to preserve the reef. A 35-year plan called the Reef 2050 Plan has been laid out to improve sustainability and investment for the reef. And other efforts are also being addressed, especially since climate change is very much global and not confined to just Australia. Corals are hardy. They can survive some bleaching events, but if conditions improve, if things turn out well, if temperatures stabilize and conditions become more favorable in the future, the zooxanthellae will re-enter the tissues of the coral and the corals can then survive. But if conditions don't improve, the coral will start to decay in the reef, and the reef will then be occupied by algae, which will prevent corals from regrowing there again. And soon, the coral skeletons will erode in the water because there's nothing to sustain it and keep it healthy, and the whole thing would crumble and collapse.